Namaskara, good evening, and a warm welcome to all our esteemed viewers. We again meet in this month of November. The month of November, we celebrate not only our anniversary, and this is the sixth anniversary of Destination Heritage, and also we celebrate the Heritage Week too. We started by having monthly lectures in 2015, and we had a good response like how we have now, and then we went on to having collaborations with reputed institutions and with the Indian Waterworks Association for our cultural activities. And the pandemic, we made use of it to have our online programs, and this is number 59 to 60 of these programs that we have conducted in the last 14 months. A nation's culture resides in the heart and in the soul of its people, said Gandhiji. But the wanton destruction happening to our heritage structures shows that we are more interested in commercials. Paper reports on 19th November, which is the start of the Heritage Week, the headline screams, Hoysala era temple collapses in Kikkeri due to incessant rains. Beautiful wall carvings and idols like Narasimha, Gopalakrishna, Mahishasura Mardini, Shiva, Vishnu, and Ganesha, to name a few, have been damaged beyond repair. And there was also an item which said that the Janardhan idol from a New York museum is due to arrive as it belonged to that temple. Had it been repaired at the right time, it would have survived the onslaught of the weather and time. Portion of the Senthil Kote in Mysuru, where the Dasara wrestling competitions takes place, also has collapsed, and wide cracks are seen all around the fort walls, and this is threatening the structure. And also the part of the bastion of Devanahalli fort collapses. So this is the start of the Heritage Week with these information, with most of the papers carrying such items. We are who we are today because of the legacy left by our ancestors. If we can piece together fragments of our history, we understand ourselves better, and it is the youngsters who must lead the way and take responsibility. And that can happen if we behave responsibly and take care of our heritage, both tangible and intangible. Today is also Kanakadasa Jayanti, which is celebrated in Karnataka in memory of the revered mystic poet and composer and singer of Karnataka. For the benefit of non-Kannadigas, I would like to give a glimpse of the eventful life of Kanakadasa. His father was an army chief commanding 78 villages and won the confidence of the Vijayanagara kings. Since Kanaka was born as a blessing from Venkateshwara, he was named Timmappa, and he was trained in the martial art as well as in peacekeeping. He came to be known as Kanaka as he found vessels containing gold coins. His compositions thus bear testimony to the wide range and quality of his education. Since he was saved from near death, he decided he will become the Dasa of Venkatesha. He was welcomed into the Haridasa fold by Vyasaraya and Purandara Dasa themselves, but met with resistance by some disciples of Vyasaraya. A unique composition of this saint is in the narrative poem of Ramadanya Charitre. After vanquishing Ravana, Sri Rama was on his way back to Ayodhya, and there he meets a lot of sages. A question arises, which of all the food grains is best? Sage Gautama praises ragi, thereby offending paddy, and the matter is settled with Rama calling ragi as Ramadanya. Our speaker today, Dr. Harihara Srinivasa Rao, holds a master's in ancient history and epigraphy with a doctorate in Kannada literature from Hampi University, Karnataka. He is an expert hydrologist, having done extensive research in this area, aided by his 34 years experience in Central Water Commission as researcher on water quality, discharge, sediment, and bed material analysis of Kaveri, Krishna, and Pennar Basin rivers. While in service, he was sponsored by World Bank on a hydrology project. He is state archaeology recognized hydrologist. He has to his credit 10 published district-wise hydrology details. He is much sought after for his talks on Indian hydrology, having given talks in Delhi, Aurangabad, and in Karnataka. He is an active member and research associate of National Institute of Vedic Sciences, Mulbagilu, and Sri Padaraja Math, Bengaluru. He has participated in international conferences and summer camps and other activities of the Sri Math from time to time. He has produced programs for All India Radio Bengaluru on ancient architecture in Karnataka, psychological and physiological aspects of Lali, which is Jogula or Lullabies, which is in coordination with the NIMHANS doctors. He is life member of Karnataka Itihasa Academy, Kannada Sahitya Parishad, and BM Sri Pratishtana Bengaluru. He is the author of two books and has presented many seminar papers at regional and national conferences. Namaskara, and a warm welcome to you, Dr. Harihara Srinivasa Rao, on to the Destination Heritage online platform. And this is a very unique subject that we discussed, and we thought, let us talk something about this, because there are many papers and people are aware of the hydrological and scientific developments on in water management. So Ragi, the humble grain, which is today making a comeback, and also one of the ancient millets. So we thought an idea about this will be a novel opening to our heritage series. A warm welcome once again, Dr. Srinivasa Harihara Rao. And now the platform is all yours for the next 50 to 60 minutes. So over to you, Mr. Dr. Harihara Srinivasa Rao.
Thank you, madam. Hello.
So you can please continue. We are you're audible, please.
Yeah, fine. Very nice. And very much thankful for you in particular, because I'm having a great affection with you on scientific analysis of our Indian culture, especially being scientists, both of us. This is a great occasion that just today is the beautiful day of Sri Kanakadasaru, who has given us the way of red carpet to both the in the life as well as to the external world, that is from micro to macro, wherever you are. So this is the I thank you very much for giving me this opportunity, and I thank all the people to hear my presentation. Now I start.
Our pleasure also. Please carry on.
Thank you. Ragi in literature, a scientific explanation. Ragi or finger millet is widely consumed in India for its nutritional value and also for being non fattening. In fact, its value-based quality and other impacts are well narrated by many great saints like Purandaradasaru, Kanakadasaru, Sarvajna, and many other poets, attributing to metaphysics, thereby showing Rajamarga, that is the red carpet which I have just mentioned, by refining the human qualities to attain mental peace and salvation. Sri Purandaradasaru a great saint of Kannada Dasa Sahitya, who lived at Hampi, Vijayanagara district near Hospet in 16th century, narrates a person who wants to offer ragi as offertory or bhiksha should have the following basic qualities. 1. Worthy character and good nature. 2. Possession, money earned with decency. 3. Blessed with good luck. Just to give bhiksha itself, one should have such a great characteristic properties, he is telling. Thus, in the Pallavi, our first two lines, he uses the word, the noun ragi. This is the beauty of Sri Purandadasa. The word noun ragi in the adjective form of grammar attributing to human character. Ragi tandirya bhikshake ragi tandirya. Ragi tandirya bhikshake ragi tandirya. Yogya ragi bhogya ragi bhagyavanta ragi nevu. Ragi tandirya bhikshake ragi tandirya. After defining the three main features of human qualities, further he explains how to get such qualities into practice in day-to-day life. To get a good nature, one has the noble intention to share the food with the needy poor. Secondly, the rich people have to start annachatra or charity homes. In general, most people indulge in talking about unnecessary things and following others blindly. Such unusual and unconcerned talks about others start spoiling one's own pious mind and destroy mental peace. Such disturbances can be dealt with by calming down the mind daily, channelizing energy, and concentrating on devotion. This can be done through singing bhajans, describing the glory of God, or being involved in such an environment, that is satsanga. Annadanava maduvaragi, anna chatravaitavaragi, annadanava maduvaragi, anna chatravanitavaragi, anyavartaya bittavaragi, anudina bhajanaya maduvaragi. Anyavartaya bittavaragi, anudina bhajanaya maduvaragi. Ragi tandirya bhikshake ragi tandirya. Mata pitaranu seviparagi, papa karmava bittavaragi, ritiya balanu baluvaragi, nitiya margadali khyataragi. Ragi tandirya bhikshake ragi tandirya. Devoting the time and serving father and mother sincerely, who are responsible to bring their children well settled in their life, will give the utmost security feeling to everyone in the family. Avoiding sinful things like stealing, telling lies, cheating the people, adopting the spiritual path of living, all these qualities will make a man prominent and respectful living in the society. He further continues, Kama krodhava alidavaragi, nema nityava maduvaragi, Kama krodhava alidavaragi, nema nityava maduvaragi, Rama namava japisuvaragi, premadi kuni kuni daduvaragi, Rama namava japisuvaragi, premadi nityadi kuni kuni daduvaragi, ragi tandirya bhikshake ragi tandirya. According to Hindu theology, Arishadvarga or Shadripu are the six enemies of mind, which are kama, lust, krodha, anger, lobha, greed, mada, arrogance, moha, delusion, and matsarya, jealousy. These are the negative characteristics of human beings which prevent man from attaining moksha or free living with good quality. What are nitya karmas? He refers nitya karma as to those duties that a Hindu is expected to perform daily. Not performing one's nitya karma leads to sin. They include such as daily duties, snana, that is bathing, sandhya vandana, praying God three times at the specified timings of the day, upasana, a yajna performed daily that have been initiated during the marriage, agnihotra, offering to fire, japa, chanting of mantras, inside with silence will give you more and more concentration and the freeness of mind internally and externally. The nitya karmas are a form of self-purification that helps the yogi remains humble as he or she sees his or her connection to the universe and his or her status in it. It also decides the status in it. This is most important. Conducting the above rituals on time regularly will lead body and mind fresh. When such action is performed along with the name of God, one will feel enlightened and freed from all the worldly worries. Sri Ramana Nadina Neneyuvaragi, Sri Ramana Nadina Neneyuvaragi, Guru Tige Baho Antararagi, Sri Ramana Nadina Neneyuvaragi, Guru Tige Baho Ranthavaragi, Tare Dare Bhavamanu Neguvaragi, Purandara Vithalana Seviparagi. He is highlighting in the last line, if Yama calls also, if death calls also, you need not worry because you are having the strength of pure heart and mind with which you have served the society as well as yourself, and thereby you will be feeling no hard or no fear in entering to the Naraka or Swarga. You need not worry because Vithala, Purandara Vithala is there to bless you wherever you are. Thus, Sri Purandara Dasaru concludes this kruti by taking the name of Ragi using the noun form in terms of adjective. He attributes his attribution of the meaning of Ragi to human character and how to get the full enjoyment of life philosophically with social morals, and practically stands as the best example in our Kannada literature. In fact, Ragi Mudde or Ragi Lump in a cooked form is regularly devoured by farmers in South Karnataka as it provides the energy they need for the day's work. It has the nature of fiber rich and contains an amino acid called tryptophan, which helps in reducing the appetite. As ragi is rich in calcium content, helps to increase the bone strength also. Rama Dhanya Charita, we are just referring in our Geetaji talk, and today is again I want to remind our listeners that whole Karnataka is celebrating Sri Kanakadasa's day, and this Ramadhanya Charita specially written, which is very rarely found in the world, that such a treatise is being written in the literature. There is a unique treatise called Ramadhanya Charita written by Sri Kanakadasaru, who was a contemporary of Sri Punadadasaru in the 16th century. It is a satirical poem for outlook, narrated in a fictional story style between ragi, that is the finger millet. It is also called in Kannada as Dare Dalaga, and paddy vigrahi in Sanskrit. Paddy or bhatta in Canada. A quarrel starts between the two grains. Who is lesser than whom? Which is lesser than the other? Lord Rama will settle the matter in the presence of great scholars at Ayodhya. The poet says about his Kriti, Ramadhanya Charita. ರಾಮಧಾನ್ಯದ ಕೃತಿಯನ್ನು ಈ ಜನಧಾಮವೆಲ್ಲ ಆಧರಿಸುವಂತದಿ ಭೂಮಿಗೆ ಅಚ್ಚರಿಯಾಗಿ ಪೇಳುವೆ ಈ ಮಹಾಕಥೆಯ ಪ್ರೇಮದಿಂದ ಆಧರಿಸಿ ಕೇಳ್ದ ಸನಾಮರಿಗೆ ಸತ್ಕರುಣದಲ್ಲಿ ರಾಮ ಪಾಲಿಸಿಕೊಡುವ ಮನದಲ್ಲಿ ಇಷ್ಟ ಸಂಪದವ ರಾಮ ಪಾಲಿಸಿಕೊಡುವ ಮನದಲ್ಲಿ ಇಷ್ಟ ಸಂಪದವ ಆಲ್ ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಆಫ್ ರಾಮಧಾನ್ಯ ಚರಿತ ವಿಚ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಅಕ್ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಬ್ಲೆಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಶ್ರೀರಾಮ ವಿತ್ ಅಫೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ನೆಸ್. Losing all his kingdom in chess play, Dharmaraja, along with his wife Draupadi and his five brothers, were living in Kamyakavana. In that period, Rishi Shandilya visits them. Yudhishthira asks Shandilya Muni to narrate the story of Sri Rama. The sage starts telling, while Rama was returning from Sri Lanka to Ayodhya after killing Ravana, along with Vibhishana, Hanuman and others, he visits many ashrams and the places where they have stayed when they were in exile previously. Gautama Muni ashrama was one among them. Gautama Muni welcomed Sri Rama and others with great joy. And as a mark of respect, the special feasts were arranged wherein many types of dishes were served. Curious about various varieties of dishes, Dasharati, that is Sri Rama, calls Hanuman and asks him to explain what was the speciality of such good tasty dishes. Hanuman replied, before explaining to him about their taste, he wants to know about the grains with which those dishes were prepared. Rama humbly requested Gautama Muni to bring the grains and present them before the audience. The following are names of grains which were presented. The names, I am going to tell the names both in English and Kannada. First Kannada, then English. Ragi, the finger millet. Haraka, kodo millet. Navane, foxtail millet. Same, little millet. Hearing the names, he was further curious to know what was the qualities of those millets. And by hearing these words, each and everyone who were favorite of this Same, Navane or Ragi, they stood up and they are telling about their good qualities. Here is the narration of Sri Kanakadasaru. Kelaru Godhiya ಸಾಮೆಯನು ಕೆಲರು ನವಣೆಯ ಕಂಬು ಜೋಳವ ಕೆಲವರು ಹಾರಕವೆಂದು ಕೆಲವರು ನೆಲ್ಲನು ಅತಿಶಯವ ಕೆಲರು ನರೆದಲಗನನು ಪತಿಕರಿಸಲು ಅದ ನೋಡಿ ನೃಪತಿ ಅದರುಳು ಹಲವು ಮತವು ಏಕೆ ಒಂದನೇ ಹೇಳು ಎನ್ನಲು ದೆನ್ He asks Gautama, Why? Each person started highlighting the quality of these grains. And he was also much astonished to hear why they are telling so many names. Why do they are not saying the specific name which is the best among them? So then the poet continues, Dasharathi Chittaisu Nammaya Deshake Atishaya Naredalagane. There is no equivalent to Naredaraga or Ragi. Vasiyullavanita Mikkina Dhanya Vekenalu Lesanadide Munipa Gautama Dosharahitanu Pakshapatava Ninu Isu Pariyali Madvare Shiva Yendana Vigrehiga Vrihiga. Vrihiga means paddy. Then Gautama Muni spoke about the importance of ragi and says that it was the best one. From here onwards, Kanakadasaru uses the technique of dialogue directly between the two and other grains. Soon after hearing this, Paddy started asking Gautama Muni, why are you declaring like this? Being a scholar, how could you think like this? I thought you are an impartial person. Don't you know, even in the presence here of mine and also wheat and others, how can you decide like this? And turning to the finger millet, ferociously, Paddy asks Ragi, burn your pride. How come you become equivalent to me? That too in the presence of Janakipati, that is Sri Rama, who is a great judge, who knows the defects of both of us. I must be... Then he boasts himself, what are his qualities? It is very nice to hear from Kanakadasa himself. Kshitiya Amararu Upanayana Dali, Kshitiya Amararu Upanayana Dali, Suvrata Bhojana Parama Mantra Akshate Galali, Shubha Shobana Dali, Aratige Hiriyarali Krutugalane Yadayolage Aramaneyali Prithidinamu Pratidinamu Ranjisuta Devarige Atishayada Naivedyatanu Ahenu Yandana Vrihiga. Just it seems to be a very dry translation, but I want to put it in little simple way. So he says that Paddy says, I must be present at all the ceremonies like Upanayana, Vratas, etc. in the form of Mantrakshate. Also on auspicious ceremonies like Yaga, Yajna and so on. My presence is a must, including the offerings of Naivedya to God, which is a great ritual and which is a food that is given to God with all the good qualities. Hearing the hard words, Nudiya keluta kanali kangalu kidi masagi kathigundu nudidanu silila ghajjanayante sabeyali jaredana vrihiya. After hearing the pride of Paddy, Ragi becomes very much ferocious and he says, Nudiya keluta kanali kangalu kidi masagi kathigundu nudidanu silila ghajjanayante sabeyali jaredana vrihiya. And he started telling his qualities. Nudige he sada bhanda ninu, nudige he sada bhanda ninnolu koduvare maruttarava kadu janana kadu jadanala ninnolane mate kenda naredalaga. Hearing the hard words and mockery, Ragi, with the angry eyes spitting the fire, started speaking like a thunderbolt, that I do not want to give an answer to the person like you, because you are full of egoistic sense. There is no necessity to talk to such a person like you and make less great of myself in front of these great people. Continuing his words, Ragi says, you will never say the truth, not even see the poor, but always back up the moneyed people only. It is your sole intention. Some of the patients cannot even eat you. Some of the patients, here he say Bananti, just a woman who has given birth to child. You are put into the mouth of calves which it cannot eat. This is how you are practically useless. Ha! Your birth is so fruitful. And see my qualities. Male dagedu, bele adagi, kshamada vileya kaladol, anna villade, aliva pranigala, adarsi salafuven. Jagavariye, yelavo, ninelliyo, ninnaya balagavudu taneliyo, irvudu. Aga, ee halavu hulu dhanyagale, yenage saridoreye, kelenda. So further narrating its worthy qualities, Finger Millet says, when there is no rainfall, crops dry, famine occurs, animals will die without food. In such an event, I will provide them with food. This is known to everybody in the world. At that time, where you will be and your relatives, thereby yourself and others are not at all equivalent to me, he declares himself. And he further says, if the rich people come and see you, you will simply neglect the poor and do not care at all. But there is no biased mind in me. I will protect everyone who comes to me, whether they are rich or poor. I am not as ruthless as you are. Go away from here. He simply bans him. Seeing this hot arguments between Ragi and Paddy, Lord Rama will become so much astonished and smiled himself in his mind and thought about how to deal with this issue. He looked at Gautama Muni and told, Paramadhanyadolibbare ivarirali sere olage aru tingalu. Paramadhanyadol ivaru paramadhanyadolibbare ivarirali sere olage aru tingalu hiridu kiridembavara paurushava areya ariya bahudin. Purake gamanisi navu nimmanu karesivu kelenuta ayodhya purige payanava mada helidana vibhishanage. Persons who are sitting here are expressing their inability to solve this dispute, Sri Rama says. Let us call Harihara, Brahma to Ayodhya, and these people also, they can only decide and find the solution. He simply dodges the time, Sri Rama. In order to know the qualities of these two grains, the other grains that are here, excluding these two disputed, let them be free. We shall put these two grains into jail for 6 months and then call them to Ayodhya. Thus declaring his statement, Rama asks Vibhishana to make arrangements to move to Ayodhya. Continuing the story, the poet writes, one day Sri Rama called a special meeting wherein Devendra, Shiva, Vishnu and Brahma along with their wives were present and summoned these two grains, that is Ragi and Paddy. On this great occasion, being an emperor of the land, Sri Rama, on the basis of his experience, looking towards Hanuman and Narada, declares that ragi is stronger than paddy, because after putting in jail for 6 months, its strength was not faded at all, whereas paddy lost its value and become very pale and thin. Then Kapila Muni, recognizing these words of Narada and Sri Rama, states that in all the nine grains, ragi is having stronger qualities than paddy, as he does not discriminate between the poor and the rich, whereas rice always supports the rich people only, but not the poor. All the people, including rishis, devas, and asuras, agreed that ragi is stronger than paddy. They simply declared. After acknowledgement of everyone, Raghava, by choosing the first letter Ra and the last letter in the name Gi, in his own name Gi, combined them. He renamed the Naradalaga, or the finger millet, as ragi. This is the ultimate truth that Sri Kanakadasa, through his vision, only recognized the importance of ragi. After importance of recognizing the importance of ragi, he has beautifully declares himself in the words of Sri Rama and others. By witnessing and hearing all the honors to ragi, naturally paddy felt very sorry towards himself, because the ravishment started too much worrying, and because of his self ignorance of the knowledge about ragi. Seeing his utter distress condition of paddy on his face, Sri Rama called him especially, started talking to him with great affection. Paddy, why are you worrying so much? When I declared ragi is supreme, you are pained by your heart heavily. It is well shown in your face. You are just trembling in this great Mahasabha. It is not only just because that he protects both human and animal kingdoms during the famine time. Except for this, there is no intention in my mind to degrade your status. That is the quality of Sri Rama. As the poet himself writes in the very early stages, you have heard those words. For us, you are like a Kamadhenu. Again, with the same tone of respect to paddy, he says, for us, you are like Kamadhenu. Please have a balanced mind and leave all the worry. You will be getting respect soon. It is by blessings to you. It is by blessings of these great people with you. Thus, completing his task of justice, sent back all the millets with a special favor of mercy. So this is how, so nicely and with his unique vision of the status of millets, the importance of millets. So he has written, and this is according to the scholars, this is the very unique one of the unique traitors with respect to the grains that is being written in the whole world. Now we shall move on to Sarvagna. Ragi in Sarvagna Vachana. As civilization goes, so does our diet. We are not giving the importance that our ancestors gave to their health. Thereby, we are suffering from physical and mental stress. So there is one proverb in Kannada. Who knows about the eating habits and what is to be eaten, he will not be affected with ill health at all. It is the proverb in Kannada. So continuing his Sarvagna Vachana, Sarvagna means who the person having all the knowledge. He is a very famous poet in Karnataka because of his straightforwardness in his thoughts and lyrics. They are woven in triplets, that is easy to remember. It is believed that he lived in 16th century. He is popular because of their alliterative structure and simplicity. They deal mainly with social, ethical, and religious issues. A number of riddles are also attributed to Sarvajna. Let us see how Sarvajna speaks about the finger millet, having the special medical qualities which create the baseline of health. At first, he gives the comparison of rice, jawar, that is jola in Kannada, and other millets. Akkiyanu timbuvanu, akkiyanu umbuvanu, hakkiyantaguvanu. Akkiyanu umbuvanu, hakkiyantaguvanu. Sikku rogadali. Rokkavanu vaidyanige kakkutaliruva sarvajna. ರೊಕ್ಕವನು ವೈದ್ಯನಿಗೆ ಕಕ್ಕುತ್ತಲಿರುವನು ಸರ್ವಜ್ಞ. ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ಎಕ್ಸೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರೈಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನ್ ಇಲ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ. ದಿ ರೈಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಅಕ್ಯುಮುಲೇಟ್ಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಆರ್ಸೆನಿಕ್ ದ್ಯಾನ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಅದರ್ ಫುಡ್ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಎ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ವೇರ್ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಆರ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ are contaminated with arsenic. High intake of arsenic is associated with an increased risk of cancer, heart diseases, and type 2 diabetes. This is the recent explanation in medical law. Due to this effect, the body will get squeezed and many a times attain a distorted shape. Even it shrinks like a bird. So the whole body will be shrinking at the end of its life, just like a bird. This action is compared to the shape of bird, as he says. Thus, one has to spend a lot of money on the doctor and other medical bills, as he has to face unhealthy living time and again. Then, what are the remedies for this? Navaneyanu timbuvanu havanagi iruthihanu. Navaneyanu timbuvanu havanagi iruthihanu. Bhavane galigavanu vala beelanu. Bhavane galigu. The difficulties. So, the physical difficulties, he said. Bhavanege ivanu vala beelanu. Ee maatu thavanavallanda sarvagna. This is not a lie, he says. Foxtail millet, this navane is called as foxtail millet in English. Like other millets, is a powerful house of nutrition, rich in vitamin B12. These seeds can offer a daily dose of ample protection, good fat, carbs, and amazing fiber content. Besides, copious amounts of lysine, thiamine, iron, and it also offers a copious amount of calcium. Eating foxtail will have a healthy body. So these are the explanations from agricultural point of view and their chemical point of view, and how these effects will be analyzed in today's lab. And this is how the foxtail millet will help to have the healthy conditions of the body. Then finally, ragi anumbuvanu nirogi endenisuvanu. Ragi anumbuvanu nirogi endenisuvanu. Ragiyu bhogigaligalla. Ragiyu bhogigaligalla. Badavarim badavarigagiye beledihudu sarvagna. So, of course, Sarvajna and Sri Kanakadasaru seems to be, it is not definite, but seems to be contemporary people, as I have already told with respect to Ramadhanya he also declares in one line, Ragiyu Bhogigaligallade. It is meant for only poor people. It is not for the rich, he says. So a person consuming the ragi or finger millet will not be prone to ill health so easily. It is grown for the sake of poor people to maintain their health and hard work. These are the golden words in the simplest lyrical language that Sarvajna Kavi puts it. So again, I will read it again. Here, he resonates the thoughts of Sri Purandara Dasaru and Kanakadasaru as explained elaborately previously. ರಾಗಿಯನ್ನು ಮುಂಬುವನು ರಾಗಿ ಭೋಗಿಗಳಿಗಲ್ಲ ಬಡವರಿಂದಾಗಿಯೇ ಬೆಳೆದಿರುವುದು ಸರ್ವಜ್ಞ. ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಮೂವ್ ಆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಅನದರ್ ಸೈಂಟಿಫಿಕ್ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರಾಗಿ ವಿತ್ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಟು ಮೆಡಿಕಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರಾಗಿ. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಹೋಲಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ಫಾಸ್ಟ್ ಫುಡ್. Supplies essential amino acids, supports a gluten-free diet, fortifies bone density, keeps blood sugar levels in check, treats anemia, boosts nervous system function. So here is another further analysis. The nutrition value in a 100 gram serving of ragi flour according to the nutrient database of USDA, that is United States Department of Agriculture, are as follows. Ragi in calories, it gives 385 calories. Total fat is only 7%. Saturated fat is only 3%. Polyunsaturated fat is 5%. Cholesterol content is 0%. Sodium is 0%. Totally, carbohydrates are 25%, which are the most important factors from point of view of medical log. I'm just concluding my talk conclusion. This talk narrates the importance of ragi or finger millet, narrated in 16th century lyrics written by three great saints, Sri Purandara Dasaru, Kanakadasaru and Sarvajna. Ramadhanya Charite, written by Sri Kanakadasaru, is very unique because of many aspects. It is a treatise written on the name of Ragi by way of his own interpretation and colorful story painted, taken from Ramayana as a base. According to scholars, there are very few treatises written on the name of agriculture products like ragi and paddy. Weaving the story, attributing satire, philosophy and practical qualities shows the artistic ability of poet without sacrificing the materialistic sense of these great grains. Though it is difficult to understand and follow the path as told in Sri Purandara Dasaru, here are human characteristics as they speak highly with respect to philosophy of the human brain, which is being checked and tested in many ways scientifically. Is Here, in the philosophical way, it sets a goal of how one should have the broad-mindedness to give ragi as bhiksha. The straightforward poet Sarvajna comparisons quality of ragi with the other millet products in relation to health stands as the best example of literature having the utmost value in today's scientific world. Thank you for hearing so much details about ragi. I thank once again Madam Geeta Badikilaya for what I can say. She is very kind enough to consolidate my papers wherever it is right, or how to enlarge the papers, and she is helping me a lot in my further upcomings from this dais. Thank you all the people, and I think I have tried to do some justice to the subject what we have just thought of. Thank you, madam.
Oh, I'm sorry. I had, muted myself. So I start once again by saying thank you so much, Dr. Harihara Srinivasa Rao. It was, I think, your compliments from one scholar to another, just exchanging ideas, nothing more than that. Anyway, thank you so much for coming on our platform. So this is a unique talk, Dr. Harihara Srinivasa Rao, interspersed with the recitations about the humble ragi and a detailed enumeration of its health benefits scientifically. You sang Purandara's popular and much loved song, Ragi Tandira, highlighting ragi's benefits. Surprisingly, it enunciates the qualities of people who want to give ragi as bhikshake. Andre, bhikshake kodbekano arhat irbeku. So that was very nicely brought out in his song and very beautifully explained. A good introduction indeed. The interesting nuggets and the dialogues between ragi and paddy made the presentation fascinating. And a better understanding of the qualities of ragi through Ramadhanya Charitre and from Sarvajna's 16th century Vachanas. Ragi Tandira is indeed my very favorite song, and this composition is a Niti Bodhana song that explains how one should live. In a charming way, ragi here is used as a pun. This song is a representation also of Sri Panduranga Vitala's story, wherein Vitala asked for some food from an old woman who said that she only has ragi roti, which he said was more than enough for him. So he came daily and requested ragi as bhikshe. So adike arhat irbeku. Even Panduranga Vittala had the humility to accept ragi as bhikshe from an old woman. So in Purandara's composition, ragi sits comfortably with the yogya ragi, bhogya ragi, bhagyavanta ragi, having dual meanings. There is a pun there. For instance, yogya plus ragi means ragi is fit to eat, but yogya plus agi is the donor should be fit to donate. Bhogya plus ragi is tasty ragi, but bhogya plus agi, the donor will also enjoy by donating. Indeed, this song is a real masterpiece. This humble food grain is an ancient millet of India, which goes back to 2300 BC, with no reports so far of its adverse effect. It's a food favored by the working classes, and which is today becoming a superfood. No wonder our former Prime Minister Devegowda popularized this ragi mudde at the presidential place, and for some time it was really a fad thing, but I think afterwards they went back to having their rice and other items. But I think it is making, the millets are making a comeback. So the peasants ate ragi and the rich had their rice, which even now seems to be continuing, but I think because of lifestyles and the diseases affecting that, I think people are now turning, doing a roundabout turn and going back to what our forefathers were eating. It's one of the nine ancient grains which is used in Naivedyas during Navaratri also. I am sure that some of us will either experiment or add it to our daily diet after listening to Dr. Harihara's very interesting and riveting talk on the importance of ragi, which he brought from literature, and how scientifically it can give us a good benefit, I mean health benefits. So I think I will now take the questions and the appreciation that are coming your way, Dr. Harihara, because most of our audience are very learned, and I really take their appreciations very seriously. So from Ukkem Satyanarayana Murthy, we hear nice introduction by Dr. Geeta and good start at destination in this destination heritage, in this heritage week, with an interesting program today. Enjoyed the narration of Dr. Harihara Srinivasa Rao Garu intermittently with poetic manner, and noted some unknown points about the subject talked about. Then from my good friend, Dr. Nagara Sharma, who is also your good friend, he says, ragi, as noticed by the archaeologists, is grown only in South India and South Africa, which migrated from Africa itself. This presentation is as unique as ragi itself, and the literary information collected from several Kannada sources is worthy to note. I congratulate the speaker and Destination Heritage. Thanks, and thank you, Dr. Nagara Sharma, for your very honest feedback, which is very much valued. Then from Usha Karan from Singapore, she says it is a very interesting info. And Dr. Nagara Sharma, with his keen ear, says, audio, please. I did not unmute myself for about half a minute, so I did not see this, but ultimately realized that I was still on, I had to unmute myself. Then also from again from Satyanarayana Murthy, he says that enjoyed the narration. No, this I'm reading it again. It has come again. Professor Nirmala Rao writes, interesting and informative talk. Wonderful. Thank you very much, Dr. Harihara Srinivasa Rao, for enlightening me on the interesting aspects of this evening's topics. So she is a nutritionist, and this holds Very much. This was of so much of interest to her. She was a professor of nutrition at the Home Science College, Bengaluru. So with this, we come to the end of a program. And I would like to thank our very staunch supporters on this occasion as we celebrate our sixth anniversary of Destination Heritage, Dr. Nagara Sharma, Professor Nirmala Rao, Vukkem Satyanarayana Murthy, Usha Karan, and Anupama Singh, which is just coming at the tip or top of my head, and many more, and Dr. Sudha Gopinath, and many more who have been supporting us all through our 60 odd talks in the last 14 months. So I thank all of you once again, and we look forward to your participation tomorrow, wherein we have another unique talk by Neelu Kulkarni, who is the great granddaughter-in-law of Mahatma Gandhi, who will be speaking on animal communication. So this is something very interesting, which I am also not aware, and I had to do a little bit of homework. So I think tomorrow's talk at about 5 o'clock will be as interesting as all Destination Heritage talks are. So thank you so much once again, and Shubharatri. See you tomorrow, one and all. So thank you again, Dr. Srinivas Rao. And we close this session on this happy note. So thank you, one and all.